In this example, we are required to find the power supplied or absorbed by each battery in the circuit shown in figure. Here, to find out the power absorbed or supplied by any battery, we need to calculate the current through each battery. And we know that the power supplied or absorbed by the battery can be written as the product of EMF and current through it. Now, to calculate the current, here we use the Kirchhoff's current law. However, we can solve the problem by using Kirchhoff's voltage law also. But here, let us consider potential here to be 0 volt. Because in applying Kirchhoff's current law, we need to distribute the potentials. So, if we take here potential to be 0 on this side, potential will be 10 volt. And if here it is 10, at this terminal, potential can be taken as 25 volt. At this junction, if we consider potential to be x, at this point it will be taken as x plus 30. Now, if somehow we are able to calculate the value of x, we can get all these currents. So, here we write KCL equation for the variable x at this junction. Here we can see there are two resistances connected from this junction where potential is x, on the other side there are two more resistances connected. So, if we apply the Kirchhoff's current law, we can say that total sum of outgoing currents from this junction must be equal to 0. So, in this direction from 5 ohm resistance, we can say the current flowing is x minus 0 by 5 plus the current flowing in this direction will be x minus 10 by 10. Plus, in this direction, current can be calculated by sum of these two currents. So, here it will be x plus 30 divided by 10. Plus, in this direction, it will be x plus 30 minus 25, which can be written as x plus 5 divided by 5 is equals to 0. Now, in this situation, if we take the LCM of these terms to be 10, this will become 2x plus x minus 10 plus x plus 30 plus it will be 2x plus 10 is equals to 0. So, now in this situation, this 10 gets cancelled out and we can see we are getting 6x plus 30 is 0, or 6x is equals to minus 30. So, here the value of x will be, this will be minus 5 volt, the value of the potential x we obtained. Now, using this value of x, we can easily calculate the current flowing in different batteries. Like if we calculate first the current flowing in 10 volt battery, then current in this 10 volt battery can be written as the sum of current in these two resistances which are supplying current to the 10 volt. So, this can be written as the current flowing in this direction we can write as x by 5 plus this current will be x plus 30 by 10. If we substitute the values of x, you can say this will be minus 5, so this minus 1 ampere plus this will be minus 5, so it is 25 by 10, that will be 2.5. So, this can be written as 1.5 ampere, this is the current which is flowing through the 10 volt battery, this is 1.5 ampere. Using this current, we can directly write the power supplied by the 10 volt battery because here the current is flowing from positive terminals, so this battery is supplying the power. This can be written as EI, where EMF is 10 volt multiplied by the current flowing is 1.5 ampere. So, this will be 15 watt. That will be one answer to this problem, that is the power supplied by 10 volt battery. If we calculate the current passing through this 30 volt battery, so this can be given as the total current flowing in these two resistances, because whatever current is supplied by 30 volt battery will be divided in these two resistances. So, here if we substitute the value of x to be minus 5, you can see that this potential will be 25 volt, and here also the potential is 25. So, we can state no current will flow through 5 ohm resistance, and whatever current is passing through 30 volt will be passed through the 10 ohm resistance, which can be given as 25 minus 0 by 10. So, this will be 25 by 10. This 2.5 ampere, that is the current supplied by this 30 volt battery, this 2.5 ampere. So if we find out the power supplied by this 30 volt battery, this can again be written as EI. Here EMF is 30 and the current is 2.5 ampere. So the result we are getting is 75 watt. That will be another answer to this problem. And as we can see, no current is flowing in this branch. We can directly state that current flowing through the 15 volt battery is 0. And power of 15 volt battery is also 0. This battery is neither supplying power nor it is absorbing power. So these are the three answers for the individual powers associated with the three batteries. These are the answers to this problem.